Here on the Phantom Gourmet, we're dedicated to finding great restaurants no matter where you live. So now Dave Andelman is here to talk about some fantastic eateries in every direction. Dave, you dine out for lunch and dinner every day of the week. So I want you to take us on a little tour of great places that you've been to recently. Let's start north of the city. We're going to go to Peabody, a place called Palana. You came back raving about this place. Tell me about it.
Well, usually I won't go to a steakhouse that's anywhere in the vicinity of a Petco.
Right.
But I violated that policy, and it paid off big time, Dan, because you walk into this place, and you can't believe it. It's a dark, gorgeous place, open kitchen, beautiful bar. These are first-rate steaks, as good as anything in downtown Boston. And I love the 24-ounce porterhouse. It's perfectly cooked on the grill. They have great sides, cream spinach, Vidalia onion strings. When I was there, I had a special cream corn with bacon.
Nice.
My recommendation here, though, Dan, and you know I love sirloin, is the prime New York sirloin. It's right up there with the best steaks that I've had. Perfect centered cut, and if you want, you can smother it in melted Vermont cheddar cheese for a few bucks more.
What do you mean, if I want? Is that even a question? How good does that thing look? You've got to be kidding me. All right, that's north. Now we're going to go south, okay? About halfway between Boston and Providence is a place in Mansfield called Trattoria della Nonna. Mm-hmm. Now, this is another incredible spot a lot of people might not know about.
What's better than finding one of those Italian restaurants run by an Italian family that just lives for food and take so much pride in what they do?
Sure.
There's nothing better. This is a cozy restaurant and wine bar. They have a wood-burning oven, so the place smells absolutely delicious. They feature Southern Italian cooking like bruschetta and a beautiful caprese salad with fresh tomatoes and mozzarella, handmade beautiful pastas, a bolognese with big chunks of beef, veal, and pork. I love the stuffed veal chop. This is their signature dish. They sort of vary the preparation, Danny, depending on the season, but they make it with saltine crackers, lightly fry for a great crispy exterior. What a great dish.
Very hearty. Looks really, really good. All right, now let's go west, young man, okay? A lot of exciting things are happening in Worcester, believe it or not. We're covering a lot of Worcester restaurants. A place we found recently and you really liked is called Evo. Tell me about the Evo.
All of a sudden, these new, cool places are everywhere in Worcester, and if got a wall of water and changing colors, just a fun vibe. The chef is a young guy, really talented, loves all natural ingredients, comfort food from all over the world here, Dan. They do some more upscale dishes like seared tuna and grilled hanger steak, but I recommend the wonderfully named dish, the Fat Albert Burger.
I love Fat Albert, and I love burgers.
This is a half-pound, all-natural ground beef stuffed with a blend of American and cheddar cheese. They bake this thing in a stone hearth oven, so the cheese melts and the burger is perfectly cooked. They put it in foil, so when you unwrap that foil, it is just a rushing river of deliciousness.
What would Fat Albert say if he bit into that, I wonder, Dave? What do you think?
Oh, my goodness. Fat Albert would get even fatter if he had exposure to this burger.
I was looking for a... but I guess we'll just move on. Now, let's go to the city itself. In the city of Boston, everybody knows every restaurant. Everyone's talking about all these fancy places. You like a place called Franklin Cafe. There's two of them, actually. One in the South End, one in South Boston now, Franklin South. What about the Franklin?
Franklin was so ahead of its time as a neighborhood restaurant doing real quality sort of upscale type comfort food.
Right.
I mean, nobody was doing that. And they're open 7 days a week, full menu till 1:30. I mean, we get that complaint all the time. Nowhere to go late at night. Open till 1:30. Their raw bar type stuff is great. The oysters. And the best thing I think to do at the Franklin is to go for brunch, Danny. They do a wonderful brunch at the Franklin. Try their French toast or their German style giant pancakes with powdered sugar on top.
Right, so you can have a cocktail, you know, and some food till 1:30 in the
morning.
Leave
at 1:30, get right back.
In the South End, then go to Southie and get the brunch the next day. Thank you, Dave Andelman. Good tips as always.